people seem to find, and how they're in a hurry to complicate their minds by chasing after money and dreams that can't come true. I'm glad that we are different, we've better things to do. May others plan their future, I'm busy loving you. One, two, three, four.
Sha la 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 la, live for today. Sha la 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 la, live for today.
And don't worry about tomorrow.
It's day one, and I've got some bad news. I'm trying to do the incline this morning. For some reason, they require reservations, and that sucks. So I'm gonna try to go there and do it without a reservation somehow. Day two. Got my sport tea. I woke up late. I think I'm still gonna try for Sherman. Probably not a good idea, but we'll see. Had to change up the plan today. I went and drove up to Iowa Gulch Trailhead, and the approach was much more snow-packed than I had anticipated. So I'm switching up today. I drove up to Evansville, is right below Mount Evans, which is a 13er right outside of Leadville, and I'm currently on my way up to that pass up there. About two-thirds of a mile in. I think we're at like 11.5. Feeling pretty good, actually. Just over 12,000 feet, about 2 miles, 50 minutes in of total time, probably like 40 minutes in of just pure walk time, but man, this area is fucking cool. I mean, you gotta love Elbert Massive in the background. Made it to the first switchback. Just have to go up there. Going down should be easy. Legs feel pretty good, so I should be able to run. Evansville Pass, but there's the Evansville shack and the power lines that you see when you're all the way down at the bottom. I've got a good feeling this storm's gonna pass pretty quick, but the wind is picking up a little bit. And that goes all the way up to Mount Evans 13er. We're at just over 13,000 feet. All right. Does it? I gotta get down. All right, that's a wrap on Evans Pass. Too hard. All right, you probably can't hear me right now because it's so windy, but I'm only 200 feet up. I'm fucking beat already. My legs are killing. The wind is rip roaring this morning. It's just coming right over the pass. Thank you.
us in that actual hike. And about almost a mile in, you probably can't hear jack shit right now. Summit. Alright, well, I went down a little bit to check it out. People in front of me are trying to like boulder traverse, which I'm not trying to do today. I don't know where they're going. It's not really sketchy right now, but the wind's picking up and I don't really know how to get down. So I'm waiting to see what these people do. But I think I'm going back. Tuesday, day 4, I am attempting Breck Peak 10 today. Weather's a little iffy, so I'm going up. I'm just gonna check it out. Everything seems to be breaking like just as it hits the mountain. So hopefully no rain or bad storms, but we'll see. I mean, it's Breck, so I can get down pretty easily. Well, about 50 minutes in, I got almost 2 miles and like 1,100 feet gain. It's definitely getting darker up there. It says it's not gonna rain though. I just don't trust the weather forecast. Made it to the Breckenridge Scenic Overlook. You've got Peak 9, Peak 10. Still looking a little dark. You can see the clouds rolling in there. Got about 1,500 feet in probably an hour and 10 minute, maybe less walk time as I waited. We got 2.5 miles in. Oh, a little patience can go a long way. There is blue sky up there, and it is now sunny. I think this stuff's gonna burn off. Well, I ran into my first literal roadblock. Alright, I'm at about an hour 45 minutes in, 2,000 feet up, about 3.33 miles in. Starting to hit some snow though. Today. Coming up on the last little bend where it shoots up to Peak 9. I wish the man would just bring. I don't know how much further I'm gonna get, but I can see the Peak 10 station right now. It's right up there. Alright, I'm headed back down. Getting tired. Clouds are getting worse. It's getting later. And the wind is picking up. So, I'm calling it quits right now. Alright, let's try this again. This is day 5. We are in Estes Park, Colorado. And I'm gonna try to summit the Twin Sisters, which overlook Long's Peak and Rocky Mountain National Park. Pretty excited, but I'm already winded, so that's great. We're getting up to the first like major lookout, and you can kind of see the trees are thinning out. So you can tell we're kind of starting to get toward tree line, but I can even see up there, tree line's still quite a bit higher. We are hour 20 minutes in, 3 miles, and just over 1,800 feet of vert. Well, made it to this cool lookout point right here. So, we just have to go up there. Honestly, closer to like an hour and 45 minutes, maybe even an hour 40 walking time. Really wasn't too bad. Kind of some fun bouldery sections though that are pretty cool. Yeah.